Okay, this is a very, very current topic and a nice topic, interesting topic. Okay, I hope everybody could listen. Everybody here in the Philippines, okay? I wish you could see and watch this video. This is a think about it video. Think about it video, okay? Tentative title, Philippine Educational System Failed in Reading, Math, and Science. Title, Philippine Educational System Failed in Reading, Math, and Science. Okay? This is a think about it. Okay? I'm not here to offer constructive changes, okay? I'm not here to offer curriculum changes, okay? I just want to offer a think about it. Think about it, okay? Think about it for a moment, okay? Just give it a chance, the thought. Maybe what I'm saying all along is the right one. And probably, if it's not completely 100% correct, probably 50%. I'm saying the right facts and the right justification, okay? Now, we in preschool, elementary, high school, and college teachers, we are now guided. Guided, okay? We are now guided by learning the fun way. Learning the fun way. We are told to do that. Learning the fun way. To do that to our pupils, okay? Teachers adjust to the learners. Take note. Teachers adjust to the learners, okay? Who have short-lived attention span and are easily bored. I just repeat again. Teachers adjust. Teachers are required to adjust. Required. That's why they were told to teach learning the fun way. That's the connection. Okay? That's the connect. That's why we have to teach the fun way. Okay? That's the connect. Because teachers have to adjust to the learners who have short-lived attention span and are easily bored. Okay? So that's the connection. Teachers are told to make the lesson. Here's the latter connection. Teachers are told to make the lesson live and alive so that the whole attention will be held for a longer period of time. Because again, back to the old point, teachers have to adjust to the students. Okay? Imagine that. You're 55 years old, 50 years old, and you have to adjust to the 16-year-old. Okay? Who had short attention span and easily bored. Okay? 16 years old to the 12 years old. Okay? You have to adjust, you the teacher. Okay? For the boredom to be moved to later. Okay? You are told to make the lesson live and alive. So as the pupils' boredom will be moved to a later boredom, later in time. Okay? Equals, effects, facts. Okay? What I'm saying is, equals? Okay, equals? What are the effects of this? All of this that I've been saying, effects, facts, here are the facts. And tests, T-E-S-T-S. Now, we have more, M-O-R-E, more. Decreased reading, decreased science, decreased math skills. We have more now, 2024. Decreased reading, decreased science, decreased math skills. I'm not making this up. This is all in the news. And this is us, think deeply about it. It has been 11 years since that was implemented to make the teaching method live and alive. Okay? To cater to the boredom of the students, to cater to the short attention span, okay? To cater to all those pupils, okay? I forgot the technical term. I just forgot the technical term. It slipped right me now, okay? I hope I can remember it later, or probably write it down later, okay? I'll write it down below. If I'll remember the technical term. Okay? Entitled. Now I remember. To those entitled, feeling entitled pupils. Okay? For the past 11 years, teachers have to adjust to those feeling entitled students. Now, they're entitled, and so therefore, attention span short-lived attention span, and easily bored because they are entitled, feeling entitled. Okay? I hope you can connect the dots. Okay? Here's my suggestion. Okay? Revisit lang, no? Balikan natin, no? What we did, what we were doing right in the 1970s, I mean, not 1990s, in the 1970s, okay? Just revisit. What were we doing right in that time in our educational system? Okay? Siyempre, no? Except, what we were doing right, except the educational system where there was parrot memorization. Obviously, that's the exception. Okay? Do not revisit that. We were required to do parrot memorization. Okay? And the tests were parrot memorization tests, quizzes, and major exams. Okay? I failed in those things. Honestly, I failed in those parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T. I failed in those parrot memorization tests, quizzes, and major exams. I failed. Okay? 1970s, when I became older, I started my school around the 1970s. And here is probably a partial proof. Me, I just proved that probably going back and finding out what's done right in that time. 1970s, 1960s, 1950s. What was done right in that time? Except the parrot memorization, okay? What's done right in that time? Proof. Proof of the right. Probably, maybe, I don't know, right educational system at that time. There was something, doing something right in that time, okay? Now, here is the proof. When I became older, I wrote in two English magazines. Take note, two English magazines. And I was a writer in two Tagalog magazines. Take note, English and Tagalog. I was a writer in two English magazines and in two Tagalog magazines. Okay? Take note of that. But. I never took up in college communication arts. I never did that. I never had media arts. I never had any subjects related to communication arts. Communication arts. I never had any subjects related to communication arts. Okay? No subjects related to media arts. No subjects. I didn't have BS English. Bachelor of Science in English. I didn't have that. Or subjects related to BS English. I didn't have all those things. But how come I became a writer in not only one, not once, but twice? Too serious subject. I have to make that joke. Okay? Not once, but twice. Two subjects, two companies, two magazines in English. And another one, not once, but twice. Two magazines, two companies, two magazine companies. The one previous was in English. The two companies now were in Tagalog. Okay? So, following that logic, I wrote for four companies. Four magazines, four companies. Two in English, two in Tagalog. Okay? I hope you got my point. I became a writer and never had any background in writing. Okay, I hope you got my point. Okay? Prime example of probably there's something in writing those times. 1950s, 1960s, 1970s. There was doing something right there. Honestly, real talk, I was good in reading, excellent in reading, science, super excellent in science. not so good math. Okay, I'm a biology expert, but I didn't have math skills. Okay, oh by the way, is that the educational system in the 1940s, 50s, 60s, 70s? That was wrong. It was me. Low in math. It was me. Okay? No educational system there. Okay? So the next sentences may not be factual, okay? I'm not going here for the facts, okay? For the exact years, okay? Exact decades, okay? I made this video so that you can have an idea of my point. What I'm coming across, okay? Not factual were the decades, okay? Before the 1970s, for decades, Marites. For decades, Marites. I heard that elementary grad then and high school level graduates were found to be good college teachers, okay, and high school teachers then, okay? So that's another example. First example, being a writer and another writer, and this is another example. There's something right they were doing in those decades. Okay, that's a second example, second proof. Why not revisit? Why not find out, tweak, TWAK, what's right in those things? What's right in the curriculum in the 1940s, 50s, 60s, 1970s? What were they doing right there? Except the parrot memorization. Okay, parrot memorization, it's not right. Okay? Now, again, facts, FACTS, and international exams, international audit. They were auditing how good we were in reading, science, and math. Okay? International auditing, international testing. Okay? And consistently for the past 11 years, we were still going down. Downward slope. Still going down. Downward slope. Reading, science, and math. Downward slope. For the past 11 years. Take note, 11 years. We are deteriorating. And the method of instruction was for the past 11 years was geared to take out the boredom of the pupils. That's what I'm focusing on. For the past 11 years, our teaching method of instruction, were geared to take out the boredom. Okay? Probably there's something wrong in that. Taking out the boredom of those entitled students, entitled pupils, probably does not correlate and does not compute. Okay? Quoting from Spock. Spock and Star Trek. Live long and prosper. unrelated words. Okay? So, let's go back to the method of instruction for the past 11 years. We were deteriorating in reading, science, and math. But still, for the past 11 years, our method of instruction was still geared to take out the boredom of the entitled pupils. Okay? Bored pupils with short attention span. Okay? I don't know. I'm not an expert there. I don't know. Maybe it's high time to stop adjusting the lesson plans for the listless. L-I-S-T-L-E-S-S. 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 For the listless pupils. Okay? Adjusting your lesson plan and method of instruction for those entitled pupils. Okay? Listless students. Baka ito ay isang factor. Kasi ano doon, pasayahin mo yung ano mo. Para lang sila naglalaro. Ganun, no? For the past 11 years, ha? Take note of that. Kailangan daw ang pagtuturo mo para lang daw sila naglalaro. At masaya sila. No? Probably, it's high time to stop focusing on making them happy. Why? They are entitled and you make them happy. I think there's no correlation there. No connection. Entitled pupils make them happy. I think there's something wrong there somewhere. Okay? Make your method of instruction making them happy. Making your lessons seem like play. P-L-A-Y. Play, fun. Fun and play. Okay? Again, the proof of the past 11 years spiraling down of international auditing of the results of science, reading, and math. Okay? For the Philippines. Okay? I think the 11 years is enough. Kumbaga, mautog na tayo. Siguro tama na yung making it fun, make it like a play, no, para na naglalaro ang estudyante. No? Siguro it's high time to revisit that. No? 11 years na eh, hindi naman umaangat. No? Takwan niyo ba yung point ko? 11 years mo na ginagawa yung lesson plan mo, parang naglalaro lang daw yun ang gusto eh. No? Para lang daw naglalaro ang estudyante at para masaya ang pag-upo nila doon sa classroom. Pero, entitled students, pasasayahin mo. No? Kaya siguro, no, ang point ko doon, siguro tanggalin na yung part na yon na pasaya eh, para naglalaro lang. No? No? para naglalaro. Siyempre, hindi sila mabobor para na sila naglalaro. Pero, ang ano eh, lagi tayong babalik. Ano yung resulta? End result? No? Ano yung end point? What's the end point? Lalong bumababa eh. Ibig sabihin, may mali dun sa pasisiyain mo sila, make it more live and alive, yung pagtuturo mo, no? Para lang sila naglalaro. Make them happy. No? There's something wrong there for the past 11 years. Again, there's something wrong there for the past 11 years. Making them happy, making it live and alive, it's like a play, play only. Okay? It's like a play event every time they went to the classroom. Okay? Guru, mautog na tayo sa catering to the whims of at saka yung gusto na academy, mag-a-adjust tayo sa ng lesson plan natin to the short attention span process of learners, no? Okay, so that's it. Pause rewind kung if you didn't get some parts of this correctly. Pause rewind, okay? It's all it here. Subscribe and follow and subscribe.